Okay. Now in lecture 8 we are going to do two or three different activities. The theme that we will be working on in lecture 8 is basically to compute the same quantity in two different ways. So if we calculate the same quantity in two different ways, we generate an identity, and that identity is very, very useful identity, at least in the mathematics subject that we are discussing. There are many unique identities, different identities that we produce because we use the theme measure the same quantity in two different ways. Now, to elaborate what this theme is, we will take first example of equilateral triangle, where triangle ABC is equilateral, and if we choose any point P inside equilateral triangle and then divide the area of equilateral triangle in three parts, draw perpendiculars from P on corresponding sides PD, PE and PF, the important result that we wish to produce is, suppose H is the height of this triangle, equilateral triangle, if we draw perpendicular, the height is H, and let the side of equilateral triangle be small a. Okay, now the idea is to measure the area of equilateral triangle in two different ways. One, by using formula for finding out area of equilateral triangle if the side length is known, and second, we have divided this area of equilateral triangle in three triangles, PBC, PCA, PAB. So if we add these three areas also, we should get area of triangle ABC. So area we denote by box. Area of triangle ABC we will say is equal to area of triangle PBC plus area of triangle PCA plus area of triangle PAB. So this is the theme. We are measuring the same quantity in two different ways, and this should give us identity. So here is a chance for you to generate that identity. Pause this video, try to do it yourself, what identity you get, and then check your result with the proof. Okay, now area of triangle ABC, if it is equilateral, you might be aware of the formula root 3 by 4 into a square. Now we have not yet proved this result, but at the moment we will assume it. Maybe in the end we will try to prove it if required. We don't want this result at the moment. We will write half base into height, so half H into A, which is equal to half PD into A plus half PE into A plus half PF into A, right? Now you observe that half A is getting cancelled from everywhere. So I, one step, if I want to add, I can take half A as common and PD plus PE plus PF, which is half A times H. So half A gets cancelled, and we get identity that height of equilateral triangle is the sum of distances from any point in the interior of equilateral triangle, length of altitudes drawn on sides. PD plus PE plus PF is equal to height of the triangle. This is very, very important property that we have got, and the theme is measure the same quantity in two different ways. Okay, so this is the first activity and we have got a very good result out of it. Now Second activity is still more interesting. Let us look at what is that configuration. The configuration is simple. We have been given a right angle triangle ABC. I will draw it little fast. This side is denoted by A, this side is denoted by B, this side is denoted by C. And now we will construct a square with sides small a plus small b. Point D, point E, F, join. P, Q, R, S, D, E, F, G. Okay. Now, distance QE is small a, distance QD is small b, small a, small b, small a, small b, small a, small b. Now, this in this configuration, we have constructed a square of side A plus B, and then at those important points D, E, F and G, we have joined those points to get this configuration. Now, because it is square, all these angles are 90 degrees. This side is small a, this side is small a. This angle is also 90 degrees, this side is B, this side is B. So, we will not write it in detail, but it is expected that you write in your notebook that these two triangles are congruent. Now, if we rotate this angle in 90 degrees, you will find that this triangle PDG is also congruent to ABC. Now, so let me write, triangle ABC is congruent to small angle, big angle, right angle. Triangle DEQ is congruent to GDP. Triangle GDP is congruent to triangle FGS. Is congruent to triangle EFR. And all these triangles are congruent because AS test. Side angle side. Now, because these all angles are congruent to each other, what do we get? We get the remaining three elements of those corresponding elements of triangles congruent. So let this angle be x, then this angle is x, this angle is x, this angle is x, this angle is x. If this angle is y, then this angle is y, this angle is y. This angle is y and this angle is y. So I am not writing it, I am showing it. You may write it in your notebook. Because of CSCACT, these two angles are equal. And we have used two sides and one angle. So we will get two angles and one side back to us. So this is small c, so this is small c side, this is small c and this is small c. Now using congruency, using these five congruent triangles, what we have ended up getting in this configuration is my DEFG, the quadrilateral that we have produced, has all the sides equal, CCCC. So, the result that I am getting is quadrilateral DEFG is rhombus at this stage. Now, if we further get into details, we find that x plus y here is 90 degree by angle sum property. X plus y here also would be 90 degree, and this is linear triple. So there are three angles in linear form. They add up to 180, out of which x plus y is 90. Therefore, we can conclude saying that this angle must be 90. Similarly, this angle must be 90. Similarly, this angle must be 90. Similarly, this angle also must be 90. Therefore, we end up getting these angles 90. DEFG was rhombus, and if all the angles are 90, we say now that quadrilateral DEFG is square. right? So now we have got four congruent triangles congruent to ABC and one square whose side is C. Now our theme comes in the picture. We would like to measure area of quadrilateral PQRS, which is going to be summation of, or shall we write, 4 times area of triangle ABC plus DEFG. This is what measuring the same quantity in 2 different ways. Now I would want you to pause this video, write down all those areas in terms of small a, small b, small c, do some calculation, do some algebra, and finally check what the final result that you get, and see if that result is already known to you. Spend good amount of time, write this in detail, okay? Pause this video. Now, because PQRS is a square with side a plus b, we know area of a plus b square is the area of PQRS. 4 times. Finding out area of right angle triangle is the most simple thing. A into B by 2, A B by 2 plus area of square DEFG, all sides are C, therefore C square. So now we know the identity, A square plus twice AB plus B square is equal to twice AB plus C square. We understand that this is the same quantity present in both sides, therefore we get a square plus b square is equal to c square. Now if we come back and compare the result, a square is length of cb bracket square plus length of ca bracket square is equal to length of ab bracket square. So here we prove Pythagoras theorem. This is the first proof of Pythagoras theorem, and very very elementary. The tools that we have used while doing this is congruency of triangles, that to SAS, and then we deduced all the information and proved that the same area can be measured in 2 different ways. If we measure the same area in 2 different ways, we get an identity, and this time the identity is Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so we have a formal proof of Pythagoras theorem in this particular lecture. Now we are free to use Pythagoras theorem for deducing our further results. So this was our activity number 2. Now in activity number 3, it is discussed that what do we mean by converse of a statement. We have mentioned this word in the last lecture, but as it is given here, if x then y, and if y then x, where x and y are some statements. Each of the above statement is called converse of each other. So if x then y is suppose the statement, and converse is if y then x. Okay, so in earlier lecture we have got perpendicular bisector theorem and its converse, angle bisector theorem and its converse. So not that every time the converse is true, you will have to really check whether the converses are true or not, and hence if the theorem and its converse, if both of them are true, we need to write complete proof of that. If one statement is true, if the theorem is true, and maybe the converse is not true, and you will not be able to write the proof of that because it is not true. In that case, only one counter example, one example which proves that the opposite statement, the converse, is not going to be true, then we do not consider that it is as a if and only if. It is only if then statement, if x then y, if y then x is not true. Okay, so that is what is the introduction of what do we mean by converses. Now you are supposed to think, the first result that we have done of equilateral triangle, that PD plus PE plus PF is the height of triangle ABC if triangle was equilateral. How will the converse be? Converse will be if in any triangle PD plus PE plus PF, where P is a point in the interior, if in any triangle PD plus PE plus PF equals height h, now the question will be which height h, but suppose we take some height, then will that triangle be equilateral? Now it is not going to be true, because it was equilateral, we could take out that half a common and then it gets cancelled, and therefore we got that property. So in that case, if we reverse the rule, that if in any triangle PD plus PE plus PF is equal to H, then triangle is equilateral, will be wrong. We can create several counterexamples having height equal to PD plus PD, PE plus PF, but the sides are different. So that one counterexample, if you give of that particular kind, then we can say the converse is not true, but the theorem is true. So there will be many cases that you will come across. Okay, so essentially lecture 8 is Pythagoras theorem. We have proved it. There will be 7 problems. Hopefully they are based on the application of Pythagoras theorem, and you enjoy solving them. We will look at some applications of Pythagoras theorem in lecture number 9. Thank you.